ladder which come from heaven. This place, heaven down to the earth. It was the connection between earth and heaven, this ladder. And he saw angels ascending and descending in this ladder. And the voice, God spoke to him. God spoke to him here in this place, okay? And this is the place. When he came back, he put the stone here and he put an oil in that stone and he built the first city, which called Bethel, the house of God. Here was the house of God, Bethel, okay? Now, let me ask you a question. What's the meaning of the letter? What's that? Why letter? What is the meaning of this dream? Somebody knows? You know the letter? We know that the first covenant which made between God and Abraham.
Today you visited already as the capital of Israel,
Jerusalem.
But do you know that Jerusalem wasn't always the capital of Israel? 3,500 years ago, Shiloh was the capital of Israel. The tabernacle stood in Shiloh for 369 years. That's a long period. Nobody was talking about Shiloh. So maybe you ask yourself, why Shiloh? Why didn't they go directly to Jerusalem? Well, God spoke with Joshua, with Moses, and Moses with Joshua. And God, there's an indication when the people of Israel traveled for 40 years in the wilderness. And then Mount Nebo, Moses died, and he passed on the leadership to Joshua. And then they crossed the Jordan here at Gilgal. So they were 14 years at Gilgal, conquering the country, dividing it up among the tribes. And then they needed the next location for the tabernacle. Well, if we read in Deuteronomy 12, verse 5, it gives us an indication. It says, rather only at the place that Hashem, that the Lord your God will choose from among your tribes to place his name there, you shall seek out his presence and come there. From the Hebrew, our rabbis and sages understand that it's talking about two places. And that's how Moses also passed the knowledge on to Joshua. It's about talking about a temporary place and a definite place. And the temporary place was Shiloh, temporary as in 369 years. But like a long time temporary. And then only the definite place. King David, after he reigned for about 7 years in Hebron, he moved his throne to Jerusalem. And the rest of his kingship was in Jerusalem. And only after that time, all the prophets started having prophecies over Jerusalem. But before that, it was Shiloh, 369 years. And the temple was built by his son, King Solomon. Well, I'll get back to that. Whoa. So this was the center of Israel. This was the place where three times a year, all the children of Israel came and visit for the high holidays. High holidays are like Pesach, is Passover, Shavuot, Sukkot. Sukkot is the Feast of the Cabins. Pentecost means 50, it's 50 days after Passover. And so the people of Israel, all Israel, came three times a year to Shiloh to celebrate. This was the center of Israel. Here it all happened. After Joshua died, there was the time of the judges. We have in the Bible, the book of Judges, we know like Gideon, Shimshon, Deborah, Jephthah. All those happened in the period of the judges, the period that the tabernacle was here. So in order to understand what is the tabernacle about, in Hebrew we say Mishkan. It means tent of meeting. Who is meeting? God and his people. So to understand about the tabernacle, I want to show you a hologram presentation about what did it look like and what was inside of it. Please continue.
Back at the foot of Mount Sinai, we were commanded for the first time to build a tabernacle. And in fact, after the giving of the Torah at Mount Sinai, the tabernacle was built. The tabernacle is a portable, temporary temple. But for 39 years, it accompanied us in our wanderings through the desert, taken apart and reassembled again and again. After entering the Holy Land, Joshua established the tabernacle in Shiloh. The Shiloh tabernacle is built of a stone foundation and wooden beams, and covered by layers of fabric, a combination symbolizing the transition from a temporary tabernacle to a more permanent one. Shiloh is to be the dwelling place of the Shekhinah, the divine presence, the holiest site for the Jewish people for 369 years. The tabernacle was comprised of two main parts, the courtyard and the tabernacle tent. The tabernacle courtyard was rectangular, 100 cubits in length by 50 cubits in width, about 50 meters by 25 meters. In the heart of the courtyard stood the altar, made of wood overlaid with copper. On it burned the eternal fire, on which sacrifices, meal offerings, and wine offerings were made every single day. Since it is forbidden to ascend the altar by stairs, the Kohanim, the priests, ascended by a ramp. Before the Kohanim begin the tabernacle service, they would purify their hands and feet in the copper laving basin which stood between the altar and the tabernacle tent. It is said that when the contributions for the tabernacle were collected in the desert, all the women donated their copper mirrors from which the laving basin was made. First thing in the morning, the Kohanim entered the tabernacle tent, the sanctuary, for the day's service. Twice a day, they burned incense on the gold-plated incense altar. A blend of 11 special spices, which were placed on the coals, and whose wonderful perfume wafted far into the distance. Once a week, 12 special loaves of bread were placed on the golden table, which stood at the north end of the sanctuary. The secret method of preparing the showbread was passed down from father to son. Every evening, the candles of the seven-branched menorah, which stood in the south, across from the table, were kindled. The menorah was made of a single piece of solid gold and ornamented with flower-like cups, buds, and blossoms. At the tip of every branch was a receptacle into which pure olive oil was poured. Ever since, the menorah has been one of the symbols of the Jewish nation. Entered the Holy of Holies. In the Holy of Holies stood the Ark of the Covenant, on top of which were the curtain and the two cherubs. The cherubs were in the form of two angels facing each other, with wings outstretched over the Ark. Inside the Ark were the tablets of the Covenant, the first tablets, which were broken by Moses, and the second, unbroken tablets. The tablets and the broken tablets lie inside the Ark. This is the place from which God's voice is heard. And I will speak to you from above the ark cover, between the two cherubs, which are above the Ark of the Covenant. The tabernacle is a place of meeting, where man meets himself, where man meets his brothers and his people, where man meets his Creator. There is much more to it than meets the eye. The clues and secrets hidden in every part of the tabernacle and its vessels are many and lofty. For 369 years, the tabernacle dwelt in Shiloh until the city was destroyed by the Philistines. It then wandered until Solomon built the temple in Jerusalem. But To this very day, it is said, if you stand where the tabernacle stood and take a deep, deep breath, you can smell, if only for a moment, the scent of the incense, which still suffuses the walls.
The spices for the anointment oil and the aromatic incense. And one of those ingredients comes from Levona. It's right behind me, far in the back. And so one of the ingredients, and we still have all the ingredients. We still, you can find them in the visitor center. And we use them in my house ourselves, because we don't only want to remember the tabernacle, but every week we have a holy day. It's the Shabbat. And we have a ceremony to end the Shabbat and to go into the next week. But we don't want to forget how beautiful the Shabbat was. So in the ceremony, we smell a little bit to that incense, not burning, but just the ingredients. It smells very nice. And that's during the week, we think back about that delicious smell and how beautiful the Shabbat was. And Shabbat is also God and people coming together. And we're now going to walk on the same road as the Israelites did for thousands of years ago. The judges, the priests, everyone that wanted to come to the tabernacle has to walk this road, because that's the only road towards Shiloh. We are going to walk ourselves on this road. So follow me. We're going to walk past by the first building, but we will stop at the second building. You see a few mosaics, and you see a building. The building is actually from the 14th century, and it's a mosque. But why did they choose this place? They referred, the Arabic people for centuries already referred to this place as Shiloh. Shiloh is Arabic for Shiloh. So they referred to this place as Shiloh, and somehow they thought it was important enough to put their prayer house here, their mosque. But it's the lower two rows of stones are foundation of an early church from the 5th or 6th century. And the most highest mosaics over there, and there on the side, those are from that same church from the 5th or 6th century. And they chose this place because they thought it was important. But we see also a lower level of mosaics. And the lowest level we see here is lower than over there. You can clearly see it's more than a meter lower. It's from an early church from the 3rd century of the Common Era. So that's about 1700 years ago. And they thought this place was important because they built it on a foundation of an early synagogue from the 1st or 2nd century. But how do we know? Well, a lot of times Christians and Arab people in Israel, when there are holy places, they also want to be connected to those holy places. So they put their buildings or their houses close by, because they want to be at those holy places from the Bible. But the early Christians, when we find a coin with a date, we know from which time it is. If we find a pottery shard, I don't know if I can quickly do so, if we find a pottery shard, and we compare it to other ones we find in Israel, we can date it back to which period. If the people of then write us something, that's really, really special, because then we can know how they thought and what they wanted to say. Well, we have here a written text in Greek from the early church, from the Christians from the 3rd century. And it looks like this, if you want to see it closer. Yeah. And in the second line, from the second letter to the 5th letter, it says, it resembles silo. It's like a C, but it's a Greek letter. It says silo, and the whole sentence is, blessed be the residents of Shiloh. So the Christians from the 3rd century, they recognized this place as Shiloh, and I think that's wonderful. If you see that all the people that lived here, also the non-Jewish people, they recognize this place as Shiloh. So what is so special about Shiloh? And what happened in the time of the tabernacle here? Discover together, but for that we have to enter the village of Shiloh itself. Follow me, please. Go to enter.
see that a modern town of Lebanon, but at the base of the mountain, there's a village, Luban, an Arab village. And the Arab visit Luban is just Arab for Lebanon. It's for the same verb. So we see the Arabs adopt Hebrew name in their own language when they came here, because we lived here much more earlier than they. But they adopt the names into their own culture. Well, the wine, the olive press you saw, is from the early Arab period, from about the 8th century. They live here also. But the floor level of where the olive press is, and the floor level of this section, this residential house of a Byzantine Roman commander, the Byzantines are the Roman Christians. The ground level is lower, and also the way of building. You see all kind of neat rectangular. Refrigerating. Thank you.
Amen. Hallelujah. കർത്താവേ നിങ്ങൾ വിഷയങ്ങളുണ്ട് ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് അറിയാം കർത്താവേ ഞങ്ങളെ ഭാരപ്പെടുത്തുന്ന വിഷയങ്ങൾ ഞങ്ങളുടെ മനസ്സിനെ വല്ലാതെ കർത്താവേ വേദനിപ്പിക്കുന്ന വിഷയങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ ഞങ്ങളുടെ പ്രാർത്ഥനകൾ കേൾക്കണമേ ഞങ്ങളുടെ യാചനകൾ നീ കേൾക്കണമേ എന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ ഞങ്ങളുടെ മനസ്സിന്റെ നൊമ്പരങ്ങളെ നീ കാണുന്ന ദൈവമാണ് ഞങ്ങളുടെ കണ്ണിനെ കർത്താവിനെ കണ്ണിനെ തുള്ളികളെ കാണുന്ന ദൈവമാണ് കർത്താവേ അത് ഞങ്ങളുടെ തലമുറ വിഷയങ്ങളായാലും ഞങ്ങളുടെ സഹോദരന്മാരുടെ വിഷയങ്ങളായാലും ഞങ്ങളുടെ ദൈവസഭയുടെ വിഷയമായാലും കർത്താവേ എല്ലാ വിഷയങ്ങളിലെ കരങ്ങൾ സമർപ്പിക്കുന്ന ഞങ്ങളുടെ അറിവിലുള്ള അനേക കപ്പൽസ് കർത്താവേ ഒരു തലമുറയ്ക്ക് വേണ്ടി ആഗ്രഹിക്കുന്നവരുണ്ട് കർത്താവേ 18 വർഷം 20 വർഷമായി കർത്താവേ കാത്തിരിക്കുന്ന അനേക പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരുണ്ട് കർത്താവേ ഞങ്ങൾ അവരെ ഓർക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ ഒരു അത്ഭുതം ചെയ്യണമേ നീ അന്ന് ഹല്ലേലൂയാ അത്ഭുതം ചെയ്ത ദൈവം ഇന്ന് അത്ഭുതം ചെയ്യുവാൻ നീ സർവശക്തനാണെന്ന് വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ ഞങ്ങളുടെ എല്ലാ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങൾക്കായി ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ ഒരു ശമുവേൽ ബാലൻ വളർന്നതുപോലെ കർത്താവേ ഈ കാലഘട്ടത്തിൽ കർത്താവേ ഞങ്ങളുടെ തലമുറകളെല്ലാം ദൈവത്തിന്റെ പ്രവാചകന്മാരായി എഴുന്നേൽക്കട്ടെ കർത്താവേ നാഥാ എഴുന്നേൽക്കട്ടെ കർത്താവേ ഒരു വലിയ ആത്മീയ ഉണർവ് ഞങ്ങളുടെ തലമുറകളുടെ മേലെ ഞങ്ങളുടെ കൊച്ചുമക്കളുടെ മേലെ എല്ലാ ദിവസങ്ങൾ പകരുമാറാകണമേ എന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ ഒരു അഭിഷേകം കർത്താവേ ഒരു അഭിഷേകം കർത്താവേ ശമ്യലിന്റെ ശബ്ദം കേട്ടതുപോലെ അടിയൻ ഇതാ എന്ന് പറയുവാൻ കർത്താവേ അവരുടെ ഒരുങ്ങുന്ന സമയങ്ങളിൽ അവരുടെ രാത്രി യാമങ്ങളിൽ അവരുടെ റൂംസിലെല്ലാം കർത്താവേ നീ ഇറങ്ങി വന്ന് അവരോട് സംസാരിക്കണമേ എന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ ഒരു പുരോഹിത ശുശ്രൂഷയ്ക്ക് വേണ്ടി ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് അടുത്ത തലമുറ ആവശ്യമാണ് കർത്താവേ നിന്റെ വരവ് താമസമെങ്കിൽ കർത്താവേ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഒരു വലിയൊരു തലമുറയുടെ ആവശ്യമുണ്ട് കർത്താവേ ഞങ്ങൾക്കൊരു അടുത്ത തലമുറ വേണം കർത്താവേ പെട്ടകം ചുമക്കുവാനും ആലയത്തെ ശുശ്രൂഷിപ്പാനും കർത്താവേ അനേക ശുശ്രൂഷകന്മാർ വീണോണ്ടിരിക്കുന്ന കാലഘട്ടത്തിൽ കർത്താവേ
are broken but the feeble bind on strength those who were full have hired themselves out for bread but those who were hungry have ceased to hunger the barren has borne 7
yes
the lord can The Lord makes poor and makes rich. He makes loaves and he exalts. He raises up the poor from the dust. He lifts the needy from the ashes to make them sit with princes and inherit a seat of honor. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and on them he has set the world. He will guard the feet of his faithful ones, but the wicked shall be cut off in darkness, for not by might shall a man prevail. The adversaries of the Lord shall be broken to pieces. Against them he will thunder in heaven. The Lord will judge the ends of the earth. He will give strength to his king and exalt the horn of his anointed.
നിർണായകമായ സ്ഥലം ഈ വെള്ളം. ഇന്നല്ല കർത്താവെ, 2000 വർഷമല്ല, 2500, 3000 വർഷമല്ല കർത്താവെ, അതിനപ്പുറം കർത്താവെ, ഇസ്രായേൽ മക്കൾ ക്രോസ് ചെയ്ത് വന്ന 3500, 4000 വർഷത്തെ ചരിത്രം ഈ വെള്ളം സാക്ഷ്യം വഹിക്കുന്നുള്ള കർത്താവെ. ആ ചരിത്രം സാക്ഷ്യം വഹിപ്പാൻ ഞങ്ങൾക്കും അങ്ങ് തന്ന കൃപയ്ക്കായി സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു കർത്താവെ. ഞങ്ങൾക്കൊക്കെ ഓരോ സമയങ്ങൾ സ്നാനപ്പെടുവാൻ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് അവസരങ്ങൾ നൽകി. അതെല്ലാം ഞങ്ങളുടെ ജീവിതത്തിലെ ഒരു നിർണായകമായ സമയമായിരുന്നു കർത്താവെ. എ ന്യൂ സ്റ്റെപ്പ് വിത്ത് ദ ലോർഡ്, യേശുമായിട്ടുള്ള ശിഷ്യത്വത്തിലേക്കുള്ള ഒരു പുതു വഴിയായിരുന്നു കർത്താവെ. അതിനായി ഞങ്ങൾ ദൈവത്തെ വാഴ്ത്തുന്നു, സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു. ഈ പാവന ഭൂമി അങ്ങ് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കണമേ. നന്ദിയോട് സ്തോത്രം, സ്തോത്രം കർത്താവെ. കഴിഞ്ഞ 10 വർഷം മുമ്പ് ഈ ഇരു രാജ്യങ്ങൾ തമ്മിലുള്ള ആ പീസ് അക്കോർഡിനായി ഞങ്ങൾ ദൈവത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കുന്ന കർത്താവെ. പിന്നെയും കർത്താവെ നിലനിൽക്കുവാൻ അങ്ങടിയാക്കണമേ. അനേകർക്ക് ഇവിടെ കടന്നു വന്ന് സന്ദർശിപ്പാൻ, ദൈവിക അനുഗ്രഹങ്ങൾ പ്രാപിപ്പാൻ അങ്ങടിയാക്കണമേ എന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥന. ഇവൻ എൻ്റെ പ്രിയപുത്രൻ, ഇവനിൽ ഞാൻ പ്രസാദിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നു എന്നുള്ള ഇമ്പമേറിയ ശബ്ദം തൻ്റെ പുത്രനെ അങ്ങ് കേൾപ്പിച്ചെങ്കിൽ, ഞങ്ങൾ ഇവിടുന്ന് മടങ്ങുമ്പോൾ ഞങ്ങളുടെ കാതുകൾ ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ ഇമ്പമേറിയ ശബ്ദം മുഴങ്ങട്ടെ. യേശുവിന്റെ നാമത്തിൽ തന്നെ.
I told you we have a lot of floods. If it's raining in Jerusalem, you cannot be here. You must go out because in 1 hour, all the water is coming here. We have great floods. It's incredible. You know, it's very dangerous. So you can see it's coming from the mountain, up from the mountain of Jerusalem to the